In today's video, we will learn some important tips to grow lots of tomatoes. Subscribe and press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update from Urban Gardening. When it comes to tomato containers, bigger is better. The bigger your container, the more soil it will hold. Containers should be at least 12 to 15 inches deep and make sure they have some holes at the bottom for drainage. You can also use grow bags for tomato planting. 18 to 20 inch diameter bags can easily accommodate two plants. Make sure they have holes for drainage, as good drainage and healthy roots go together. They grow in most types of soil except on heavy clay soils, which greatly obstruct the root growth. Tomatoes thrive in rich, well-draining soil. For the soil mix, you can take 60% garden soil and 40% compost. In compost, you can take leaf mold, cattle manure or vermicompost. In hot climate, you can use 50% garden soil, 30% compost and 20% cocoa peat. Cocoa peat will hold moisture for longer period of time. Tomatoes are one of the few vegetable plants that like to bury their stems in soil. Snip or pinch off the lower leaves and cover with soil up to the first set of leaves. Remove bottom leaves before planting. Plant them as deep as possible. You can see the tomato stem has hundreds of tiny hairs, and when these come in contact with the soil, they form stronger roots. This will help to form a strong root system, which in turn will grow a high-producing, disease-resistant tomato plant. This in turn means stronger, healthier plants that need less water and fertilization, as their extensive root system can reach deeper into the soil, pulling up moisture and nutrients. Sunlight is one of the most important aspects of growing tomatoes. For good growth, make sure your plants get at least 6 to 8 hours of sun per day. So whether you are growing on ground or in containers, you have to choose a location which receives maximum amount of sunlight. As tomato plants grow, pinch and remove suckers that develop between the stem and the branch. They normally won't bear fruit and will take energy away from the plant. Removing suckers at the right time directs energy towards creating and ripening fruit instead of making more leaves. Try to remove suckers when they are small enough to pinch with your fingers, so you don't leave a gaping wound or a scar on the stem. Tomatoes are self-pollinating plants. Each flower contains both the male and female reproductive organs. This makes pollination easy because each blossom releases pollen from the stamen to land on its own stigma, and once fertilized, fruit develops. Tickle every open blossom and repeat every couple of days until the plants stop flowering to ensure every blossom on the plant is fertilized. Typically, tomato fertilization is achieved through buzz or wind pollination. To mimic the conditions of either wind or buzzing insects, simply shake or tickle the flower. When a pollinator visits a tomato flower, they use vibration to make the pollen fall from the male flower part to the female flower part. Duplicating the vibration is a great way to encourage pollination. Repeat every couple of days until the plants stop flowering to ensure every blossom on the plant is fertilized. Remove unwanted plants and weeds from the growing space as they suck out essential nutrients from the soil and spread diseases. Dig up weeds from the soil, carefully remove as much of the roots as possible and do not allow them to flower. Work the soil only deep enough to kill the weeds, being careful not to damage the plant's root system. You must dispose of your weeds and unwanted plants far away from your compost pile and garden, or they will regenerate themselves in full force. As tomato plants grow 1.5 to 2 feet tall, add some support to keep the plants upright. Use whatever stakes you have on hand, wooden stakes, bamboo, metal, just be sure that they are at least 4 to 5 feet tall. When tomato plants get really large, they will naturally fall to the ground, leaving them more susceptible to disease, pests and rotten fruit. Tie the stem with the stake with the help of a thread or twine. Tomato plants will grow healthier if they are offered support to keep the plants upright. You can also build cage-like structure with the help of bamboo stakes. They will hold up for many years and allow for carefree growing. In this system, the plants are supported both vertically and horizontally by the bamboo stakes. This type of support structures can be costly in terms of money and time, but can pay off at harvest time. Tomatoes are typically easy to grow vegetables, however, they can suffer from attacks and infestation by a wide range of pests. To ensure a healthy tomato crop, you can make an organic homemade spray. For that, take neem oil or neem liquid fertilizer. Raw turmeric, you can also use turmeric powder. Whole garlic bulb. 1 liter water, crush turmeric and garlic into small pieces and put them into a bowl. Now pour 1 liter water over it. Add 10 to 15 ml neem oil and let it boil for 10 minutes. So that the garlic can infuse the liquid with its potent sulfur compounds. Once the mixture cools down, strain it to remove the chunks of turmeric and garlic. Spray plants to deter pests and disease. This mix has antibacterial, antifungal, and insect repellent properties. It will eliminate a number of common garden problems. Spray after every 5 to 7 days for effective results. There is no need to guess when to water your tomato plants. Just touch the soil with your hand. If it feels dry, it's time to water. Ideally, your soil should remain little moist at all times for constant growth. There are three states of soil. First one is dry. In this state, soil contains minimum or 0% of water. Second one is moist. In this state, soil contains ideal water percentage, which is perfect for constant growth of the plants. Third and the final state is wet. In this state, soil retains excess water. For healthy, constant growth, we have to keep the soil little moist at all times. The goal is to try to keep the soil evenly moist. Water your tomato plants when the soil feels dry to touch. Water deeply at the base of the plant. Do not water on the foliage, as it will attract fungus and other diseases. Tomatoes are amongst the hungriest of vegetables. They must have an abundance of soil nutrients in order to thrive. For healthy growth, add compost such as vermicompost, cattle manure or leaf mold after every 12 to 15 days. Lack of nutrients in the soil is the main reason most people fail at growing tomatoes. Tomatoes particularly need a lot of nitrogen to grow strong and tall, and more importantly, to develop delicious fruits. Compost has all the basic nutrients, both macro and micronutrients, that are usually absent in synthetic fertilizers. Compost releases the nutrients gradually, thereby providing long-lasting nutrition. It not only helps in fertilizing tomatoes, but also helps the soil to retain nutrients and water. It neutralizes the soil and adds beneficial microorganisms to the soil. You can also use seaweed fertilizer. It is a broad spectrum fertilizer that is rich in beneficial trace minerals and hormones that stimulate plants' growth. Mix 15 to 20 ml seaweed concentrate into 5 liter water. Mix well and add 300 to 400 ml per plant. Seaweed is high in carbohydrates, which are essential building blocks in growing plants, and low in cellulose, so it breaks down readily. Seaweed has a natural salt content which repels slugs. We can also use rock phosphate, which is normally termed as rock dust. It is an organic fertilizer which contains phosphorus. It provides just the right amount of nutrients to make plants strong and healthy. If you use rock phosphate in your vegetable garden, you will have fewer pests, greater produce and richer flavor. After your tomato plants reach 2 to 3 feet tall, remove the oldest leaves from the bottom. Remove leaves which touches the ground and are closest to the soil. This reduces fungus problems because the leaves are usually shaded by the rest of the plant, and this will also keep the plant open, airy and free of pest and disease.